In this video, we're going to look at Minesweeper, which you can play on your phone, you can play on your PC. I'm using the free Google version right now. And I want to give you some tips and tricks on how to solve Minesweeper. These work for any level, you know, basically hard is just bigger, easy is just small. You can do whatever. So all you're really going to want to do to get started is just click anywhere, you open it up, and the first thing you want to do is just hit the easy squares. So the easiest squares are always the corners where there's a 1, because you know that there's a mine there. There absolutely has to be a mine there. So we can just do that. Now we have to find a reference point. You know, where can we break into this and get some more exposure on the map as we clear this minefield? So really the only thing that we know for sure on this one is that this is actually the only playable square. And what I mean by that is, you know, these say 2, so there's 2 mines around here, but we don't know which of these squares it's in. And in this one, we know there's 1 here, but it's either in this square, this square, or this square. And so if we use any of those squares, there's a 1 in 3 chance that we're actually going to land on a mine. But because this one has a mine, this one can't have a mine. So we're going to open it up, and that didn't give us a lot more information. So this is actually turning out to be a bit of a harder one. So we know that there's a mine there. And we're in an interesting spot here because we actually are going to have to gamble. There's no obvious mine that we can press. And so we're going to have to take a risk. And obviously when you're taking the risk, you want to do it to maximize the probability of not landing on a mine. And so, you know, if we go here, we're actually 1 in 3 of hitting a mine. Same as over here, same as over here. In pretty much all these spots, there's a 1 in 3 chance. So what we want to do is minimize that, and we're going to do that by, actually I think that we have to take the 1 in 3. I actually don't think there's a better alternative. I was hoping that we could do a 4, but there isn't an opportunity. So we're just going to gamble, and that gives us not quite enough information either. We know there's a mine here or a mine there, so those are 1 in 2s. So the probability of hitting a mine is actually higher, so we're not going to have either of those ones. So we're going to gamble again for a 1 in 3 chance, and how about we give this one a try? So that one doesn't help us either. The 2 could either be here or here, so these are 1 in 2s. This one actually does help a bit, so this actually gives us a 1 in 5 chance, because we know there's a mine here. It's a 1 in 5 chance, but we don't want to hit this corner because this corner is a 1 in 2 chance. So we're going to hit either of these 3. This one's also a 1 in 2, but these ones are actually better. So we're going to hit them. And again, not a lot of help, but we know that, that there's no mines in this area probably. So we're going to go over here, got a little bit opened up there. So we finally managed to get another mine. We know because, actually this one could be 1 in 2. So we actually don't know it for sure. So that's gonna be a 1 in 2. It's very likely to be a mine here. But if there is, there's not here. So we can almost solve that piece. We're gonna have to gamble again. And we are gonna have to gamble again. And gamble again. So all these times when I'm gambling, I've actually been running quite well, and I actually probably should have lost this game because I've done more than 3 1 in 3 chances. And so just probabilistically, I'm going to lose this game fairly often. I mean, it's on the hard mode, so that's obviously not making life a lot easier here. And we keep getting into these spots where we basically have to gamble these 1 in 3 chances. So we'll go again, and again, and again. I'm just going to try and open it up. So what I was trying to do there was just to open it up and see if I can get a better approach without gambling, but obviously that didn't work. I got unlucky and hit a mine. So that's pretty much the game. I mean, what you really want, and you know, here this is an easier start, we know just always start with the ones, and then you just use the solved pieces to solve what's next. So, for example, we know over here that there's a mine here, and this only touches 1, so both this square and this square are actually free, so we can just hit those. And the same thing over here, we actually know all three of these squares are safe, so we're going to take them all. And this opens up this one. We know that because of this one, it's only touching one block, and we know that's a mine. And we'll clear out some squares over here as well. And these are actually good because the ones are connected to this line. So we get rid of all of this, this one as well, and that one. And we know that this one's a mine, and we know that this one's a mine. We know this one because this two is only connected to this square and this square. So that must be a mine. And it's a free one. And we know this square is available because of this one touching this one. So, that's not what I meant to do. We can just turf that flag, and we can open it up. So we know this one's a mine because of this two. So two squares there. So we basically just keep solving the puzzle like this. That's pretty much it. If you like this video, it really helps my channel if you subscribe. I'm trying to build out a bigger channel. And let me know what you'd like to see in the future. I can play pretty much any game, tutorials or walkthroughs, that kind of thing. So thanks for checking out this video, and I hope you have fun playing Minesweeper.